got the score for this, we had a massive reconstruction because between the parts and the score, we couldn't figure out heads or tails of it. They were so messed up. So this is one of the reasons why they're only doing one movement, because by the time we got the music in order, it took a lot of waste of time. But it's kind of a cute piece. Okay. Oh, we're next. All right. Okay, so we're doing the great string quartet opus 18, number 2 of Beethoven. He wrote 6 in this early series of quartets. Actually, 4, the C minor is suspected that it was from a later period. But anyway, these are lovely. And we started off thinking we would just do the first movement, the Allegro, but a couple of days ago, I think we decided to add the last movement. So it's a little rough around the edges, but I think we'll try to manage it.
Thank you. Thank you.
see me coming up, right? Have to admit, we're always short of violas. So you see, my wife is playing viola, I play viola. Kirsten played viola last night. There's no viola. Two violins, cello, and bass. Okay, we have the Handel Halverson Pusatazi.
Oh, hello. Oh, we're gonna be,
So I don't know which is the original, but can be done either with violin and cello or violin and viola. But this is a hell of a fun piece. Very virtuosic and impressive piece. Pasacaglia, but it's basically theme and variation. So.
And I believe the original version is violin and cello. Violin viola. And that what I read was the most common one right now is this version. That's what's being played these days. For whatever.
Well, I can't play cello, so I like it.
There you go. Yeah, I'm pointing him out. So we can see him.
Great.
See him here. Yeah. Take your time. Get your tension of the bow. Sometimes when you're playing outside, I've noticed, you have to tell me string players if you can cut, but all of a sudden you find your bow is a lot tighter than you meant for it to be.
Yeah.
So as it gets warmer, my bow tightens, but my strings get flatter. So we always
the intonation is the biggest problem. I always tell the story because one of my favorite violinists was Joshua Heifetz, and of course Fritz Kreisler. But when I got into the New York Philharmonic, I did hear Yasha in live performance at Carnegie Hall twice, but I never heard him with the Philharmonic. But they told the story. They used to play at the pavilions in the summer outdoors, and he played drums. Something like 100 degrees and 105 humidity or something. And of course he never, he played with the tails and whatever, no matter what that was. But anyway, they said that he played with a lot and he finished first. And he went to tune the violin and it was like a whole step off. I mean, the strings were, they said, how could any human being play in tune with the instrument so far out of tune? And he would do that in a master class. Somebody would like stop him and start the tune. He said, you can't do that in performance. What are you, crazy? You gotta play, you have to play in tune. Doesn't matter what the strings are doing. So it's pretty amazing in those days, because we had guts. I started with gut strings. So you know what they're like, right?
Did sure, because we used to say in viola da gamba concerts, it takes longer to tune than to play the music.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all gut strings, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they just keep going out of tune, up and down. Yeah, it's a roller coaster ride. Okay.
All right, have fun, you guys.
Thank you.
had Schubert piano trio last night. We had the piano inside and the players outside. We're going to try something new. We have to move the piano back, I think, right? They're playing indoors, right?
No.
You may need hearing aids. Especially for the strings. Where is the keyboard? Is it that right place on the keyboard?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. That way a little?
So you are going to be inside?
Yes.
Look, to you? You want it angled like this?
It's not that bad, but this way it's better. Yeah, that's good.
Can I get this up first?
Yeah, honey, put your cello right there and then go get your chair.
It's a little dangerous, so you have to right in front of it. Is this my, oh, okay.
Honey's gonna grab her chair in a minute.
Hi, honey, you move first.
Yeah, your cello.
Then I move.
You need help?
She's gonna grab a chair.
Oh, which chair do you want?
Yeah.
The one right there.
Honey needs a chair.
Yeah, we need that.
Oh,
thank you.
Yeah, I can do that.
That one?
Yeah,
same one.
Yes. I'll move it forward if I can. I'm gonna move it a second. Yeah.
I think you need the light.
The engine holder that I have will probably hold it.
I have one.
You have one that'll hold. I want you to still be able to move. All right, have fun, guys. Can sort of detect.
Thank you.
Yeah.